Hi, Craig James, with a look at the overseas financial markets for Tuesday. Well, US shares were mixed on Tuesday as investors assessed a raft of earnings results. The Dow Jones index of 30 stocks fell by 96 points, or 0.3%, which was significantly weighed down by the shares of 3M, down in the order of 11% after the company provided negative guidance. If we look at the broader market, the Standard & Poor's 500, it actually rose by 0.3% to fresh record highs, and the Nasdaq rose by 0.4%. Pretty broad-based in terms of the gains. 7 out of the 11 industry sectors rose, and 19 of the 30 Dow components. Now, there was a raft of company news overnight. Shares in United Airlines, they were up by 5.3% after beating earnings forecasts. Procter & Gamble was up by 4.1%. Verizon was up in the order of 6.7%. But on the negative side of the equation, we had D.R. Horton, the home builder, down in the order of 9.2%. Johnson & Johnson down by 1.6%, and General Electric down in the order of 1%. In terms of economic news, the survey done by Richmond Federal Reserve, it was a negative reading of negative 15 in January. That was worse than expected, and certainly up from the previous month of minus 11. In terms of the European markets, stocks were lower broadly. They were down by 0.3%, although the UK market ended flat. US bond yields, 10-year yields up in the order of 4 points to 4.14%, and US 2-year yields were basically unchanged. Oil prices were weaker overnight. The NYMEX price fell by 1.1% to $74.37 a barrel. But base metal prices were higher on hopes for a new stimulus coming out of China. The gold price, it was higher as well, up by $3.60 or 0.2%. And the iron ore price was largely unchanged overnight. It rose by just 6 cents. Now, we've got the Aussie dollar a little bit softer, down around about a third of a cent from the highs, down to 65.7 US cents. In terms of the share market, the share price index on the futures exchange pointing to a gain of somewhere around about 13 points or 0.2% at the start of trade. We have heard from Netflix after the bell. Netflix subscriber numbers up by 13.1 million in the last quarter. The expectation was only 8.8 million. And what we saw is Netflix shares are currently higher by around about 7% in after hours trade. Later tonight, we will hear from the likes of IBM and Tesla in terms of their earnings results. Here in Australia today, we've got production reports to dissect, including those from Pilbara Minerals and Woodside Energy. And across the world, we've got what's called the flash readings, or the early estimates of the purchasing managers indexes that will be released in Australia today, as well as the US and Europe later tonight. And on that note, I'll leave it with you. Have a very good day.